Facebook Live, we have arrived. Let's get it in one more time. I want to thank everybody for chiming in. This is Watchman Yahuda Israel, also known as Pastor Derek Mann, on Early What I See Through Scripture Study and Prayer Line on this 15th day in January, one of the extra months that they added, 2019. Let's get it in. It's funny to wake up in the land of in the dispensation of a whole lot of lies. Sleep people be saying, what are you talking about? Anyway. since I just woke up, we're going to just do something we're going to go to, I just like preaching the gospel, to be honest. And got to always be deep, right? Because we need to go over three. Three and 16, y'all. I wish I'd have brought my water. Good morning, Trinda. Boca 12. Miss Pica, Boca 12. Again, St. John 3:16. Excuse me, y'all. Literally, I just woke up, so y'all bear with me. St. John 3:16, look what it say. Did we pray? I don't know. I'm going to pray anyway. Spirit of the Most High, we love you and thank you for this opportunity to come before you, humbly, as we know how. As you send a relevant word to this to your people that we may grow thereby. We're completely dependent on you. And then in the matchless name of Yahushua Mashiach, we humbly pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah, and amen. Let's get it in. For Yah so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. In the beginning was the Word. And when Adam and Eve sinned, they ran and hid. And in the beginning, the word records that the Word was walking in the garden, and Adam and Eve, you know, ran and hid themselves, you know, from the Word. Go read it. It literally is talking about the Word was walking in the garden. And they hid themselves. And, you know, the Word said, you know, it was Yah, but, you know, he can talk. The Word, right? Where art thou? And, you know, he said he hid himself and, you know, all that old fun stuff. And then if you read in the same John, the 10th verse, it said, he was in the world and the world was made by him and the world knew him not. So it said, and one, in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with Yah and the Word was Yah. So the Word was with Yah in the beginning. He could talk. In the beginning was the Word was with Yah and the Word was Yah. He can talk. All things were made by him. And without him was not anything made that was made. And if you go to the beginning, you can see he spoke everything into existence in the beginning. He was talking. His word was with him. He didn't have laryngitis, right? And the 10th verse then said, he was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own received him not. But many as received him, to them gave he the power to become the sons. Okay, you know, the children of Yah. Is that cool? The 14th verse says, and the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. So the word became flesh. How? It was born of a virgin. Was it a female? No, it wasn't a daughter. It's not the daughter of Yah. Was it a male? Yeah, it was a son, the son. So, say John 3 and 16, for Yah so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, the only begotten, the only born of Yah. Yah was literally born of a virgin, right? Philippians 2, being found fashioned as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient on death, even to death on that struos, on that tree. King James Version calls it a cross. So, for Yah so loved the world, that was a lot of love to love his creation, and his creation turned out to be pretty wicked, patterning themselves after Satan as opposed to their creator. But he so loved us that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. So if you believe in the son, what was in the son? And the word was made flesh. The word was in the son. And if you believe in the son, you shall have everlasting life, because Adam didn't believe what was in the son. The son wasn't born yet in his day. But what was in the son was born, the word. So the word came down 42 generations, being found fashioned as a man, to come give us the opportunity to get to know the word for ourselves, so we can quit blaming Adam for the stuff we do. Don't people do that? Like to blame Adam and Eve for their behavior? Well, the word came down 42 generations, born of a virgin, to reintroduce himself to us. Yah didn't send his son into the world to condemn the world. Why? Scandalous as people is. Because the world was already condemned. People was living terrible. People screwing everybody, lying, getting drunk, pimps and players. And I came up on Superfly and Coffee in them, Truck Turner, yeah. The Mac. Yeah, that's what they fed us. And they was drunk on some other stuff. That's why they fed us that stuff. They were so wicked. They the ones that was feeding us that type of media. at the Roxy. Remember the Pussycat? You ain't got to go to the Pussycat no more. It's on TV. It's in the kids' cartoon. Even the cartoons is sexy now. We up under a wicked regime, y'all. So he didn't send his son into the world to condemn the world. Look at the world. But that the world through him might be saved. And he's clear on the mights and the ifs. Because you don't have to. Prayerfully, people listen to the word and will allow the word to come change them, put an end to their sinful program. That's what he sent his son for. For Yah so loved the world, he loved us because our actions and our lifestyles is leading us to damnation. It's exactly what it's doing. You want to know why it appears like the devil is winning? Because of sin. If everyone just pumped their brakes, repented, and came to the Most High, this foolishness would stop. But the devil know how to resent any good to you. He presents it good to you, don't he? He presents a scandalous lifestyle to us, and it feel good. It feel good to illegally make love. It do. It feels great to have multiple people join the session. It feels wonderful. Can I preach like that? Why can't I? People doing it. But for Yah so loved the world that he gave the solution, his son, to be the representative of what a perfect life should look like. His son. To live the example. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. The very word that created everything in the beginning came down to earth as a participant, being found fashioned as a man, to show us what we should be doing. And we're without excuse. We're literally in rebellion when we do us, especially when we know him. We're walking in the spirit of rebellion. Bless you. How you doing, Aria? Good to see you home, young lady. You know I love you, young lady, like a daughter to me, man. But for Yah so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him, we got to believe in him. We got to believe in him. Believe in what he said. Because that's what he talked about. The word was made flesh. He was filled with the word. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. That we might have eternal life. You don't have to have it, but you can. And those that belong to him is going to receive him. If you don't belong to him, you're not going to receive him. The best you can do is just become religious, having a form of godliness, denying the power thereof. We got to get the real thing. And you got to grit your teeth in order to live this life. You got to grit your teeth. You got to be willing to go against yourself. It's difficult for some people to mark themselves as the enemy. Your evil nature is your biggest enemy. It ain't the devil. It ain't your mother nor your father. But it's you standing in the need of prayer. Your biggest enemy is yourself. So Yah didn't send his son into the world to condemn the world. We're already condemned. Look at this. You want to categorize? Then he didn't send his son into the world to condemn the world. If you want to individualize, because the world is made up of individuals. You want to take it personal? Because he did it for you on some personal stuff. If you look at yourself and the things we say and how we live, it's not right. And we need to start getting disciplined to the point that we're willing to obey the word that came to rescue us. There is a rescue mission going on. Don't you want to be a part of it? Don't you want to be a part of it? You're right, Aria. We gotta rest in his word to the point of self-denial, because there's a whole lot of stuff we want to do that he don't agree with. And we're quick to like negotiate with him or believe that it's more user-friendly than it really is. He's pretty user-friendly, but he's definitely purpose-driven. And that's to destroy the works of Satan, and the works of Satan is sin. To destroy the rebellion in us. And he didn't send his son into the world to condemn us. That's not what it's about. We're already condemned. Right? We feel condemned if we're going against him, and we should, unless our conscience is seared with a hot iron. You want your conscience working. Feeling condemned is not a bad thing if you're going against Yah. Not feeling condemned and you're going against Yah is a terrible thing. It's terrible. Couldn't be nothing worse for you. It's terrible. Terrible to be going against Yah and you're in danger of hellfire and you feel great. That's why certain people, the word was talking about people with itching ears, looking for certain type of teachers that don't make them feel bad. Well, you want to feel bad if you're doing bad. Don't you? What's wrong with the world is Satan got us manufacturing children that don't feel bad. They don't have no conscience. They don't have no shame. They don't have no shame and no conscience. You know how evil that is? That's why they'll do anything. That's why they kill. That's why they ain't got no respect. That's why school is getting tough. It's getting tough being a teacher now. Because children is off the hook because they don't have no shame. And they don't have no conscience, no fear. So Yah didn't send his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved, might be, right? Whosoever will, let him come. He that believeth on him is not condemned. See, when we take, oh, it's messed up when we got a filter programmed by religion, by false prophets, by this fake religious system. When we get our senses like shaped by that system, then you don't get the real food in the scripture. You it's heck of paper thin. See, Catholicism have you looking at the word from a paper thin as opposed to getting deep and getting the true definition, the true meaning of what he's really saying, right? That's why he told us in all thy getting, get an understanding. And people's understanding of this scripture is like heck shallow. What it's saying is, he that believeth on him is not condemned. The shallow approach would be, you believe that he exists. That's the shallow. Or you believe that he died for your sins and rose again. That's the shallow part. The shallow definition is, it's all on Jesus. And that's why they say Jesus did it all. And that's the state of mind. Oh, I'm just a sinner. Jesus did it all. I'm special. I get to go along for the ride. That's how people think. Not knowing, this is saying, he that believeth in him is not condemned. He that believeth in the word that he spoke and is living it. That's what this is really saying. But people don't get that part because they're not taught that part. The preacher didn't preach that part. He that believeth on him is not condemned. But he that believeth not is condemned already. See, he that is not living it already, and that was the state of the world. That's why he didn't send his son to condemn the world. The world was already condemned. They were living any kind of way. But he that believeth on him is not condemned because he believed in the word and start living it. Start obeying it. Start saying, no, I can't do this. I can't go there. I can't say that. I can't sleep with them. I can't get high. I can't. That's the true believer. He that believeth in him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already. You've been living like the devil. That's why he came. Because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten of Yah. It's deeper than believing in his name, Yahushua. It's deeper than that. It's believing what the name represented, and the name represents Yah. The name represents the word. That's why you can't just have a shallow reading session. Because you'll go in reading evil and come out reading evil. No, in all thy getting, get an understanding, right? Look what this says, 19 verse. And this is the condemnation. Here we go again. I didn't talk this before. I'm going to teach it again. Because the word read this before. And it's reading the same again. And this is the condemnation, that the light is coming to the world. The problem now becomes, he didn't send his son into the world to condemn the world, but he came to rescue you. So the problem becomes, people don't want to rescue because they want to stay evil. They want to continue doing what they want to do. And this is the condemnation. That's the problem. You think it was a problem when you was just in sin? That was a problem because the weight of sin is death. But the problem is officiated. It's official. When I come with a lifeboat and say, get in. And you say, nah, I like swimming butt naked drunk on drugs, making love in the water. Blaspheme against the Most High. I'm cool. I don't even believe there's a Most High anyway. If there was a Most High, why am I in this water? You don't want to get in the boat? You sure? The Most High don't want to sink the boat. Nah. This is the condemnation, that the light is coming to the world. And men love darkness rather than light. Nah, no thank you. At least you was polite about it. No thank you. I'm too busy. I got other plans. No thank you. This is the condemnation that the light is coming to the world. I'm doing fine. I'm eating. I got my money. Got my little family. This is the problem. This is the condemnation that the light is coming to the world. And men love darkness rather than light. Like, I like doing what I'm doing. I already got a church. Is your church Catholicized? Is it paganized? Because it's a lot. We've been lied to so much. And in the last days, the truth is being revealed. The seals is being unleashed right now. Knowledge is on the increase. There's a lot of stuff they lie. They're liars. Oh boy, are they. And this is the condemnation that the solution is here. And people are not interested in the solution. They're having too much fun in the pollution. Folk, it is so cool to put everything on Jesus and I get to do whatever the heck I want to do. That's why church is filled with adultery, fornication, homosexuality, and even Christians are so weak now, they're siding with homosexuality on some, God loves everybody. Oh, so his mission changed? He didn't come to destroy the works of the devil? It's not a sin anymore? Oh, times are changing. Yeah, folks is getting more and more wicked. Folks are disobedient. There's a great falling away taking place right now. You a part of it? On some old, times are changing. You need to get with it. No. Come out from among them and be separate. Save yourself from this untoward generation. Do you understand this generation is not going towards Yah? They're untoward. They're going in the opposite direction. I'm not getting with the devil. Call me the bad guy then. Being the bad guy in this religious system is a good thing. Please believe me. Woe unto you when people speak good of you. So did the fathers to the false prophets. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he have not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of Yah. And this is the condemnation, that the light is coming to the world. The solution is here. Who gonna sign up for that? Who's willing to take up their torture stake and follow him? Because if you don't suffer with him, you won't reign with him. And the ordained suffering for us is self-denial. We're such a hot mess that the suffering that he's talking about that we need to undergo is self-denial. Learn to tell yourself no. No, you can't sleep with him. You big old fine male or female, buff brother. I'm not interested in the brother. Not even a little bit. Fist bump the dude, dog. What's up, Mike? No, you don't look good to me. This is the condemnation, right? That the solution is here. And the devil is so scandalous and slick that he tried to become an angel of light to fool folk, and he did a masterful job at that. He's the problem and the solution. And that's how his children get money. They cause the problem, and then they come with the solution. And that's how they're paving the way for Satan. They're causing so much chaos and so much destruction and so much damage to the earth. And then they're going to pave the way for Satan to come fix it. That's what they do. They get their hands on your government, start printing your money. That's his children. Them that say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan, they're printing your money, and they get you in debt. And they're printing the heck of it in America right now because they're finna overthrow the economy. That's why America is like, what, $17 trillion in debt to them? Because they keep printing it. And the money is fake anyway. It's monopoly money, according to 1933, when they bankrupt America. Look it up. 1933, they bankrupt America. Came in with the birth certificate, the birth certificate, the Social Security card, the FBI, the CIA, the IRS. They came in with all that, took all the gold off the streets, and gave people this fake money, this monopoly money. So every time you spend a dollar, it ain't nothing but an IOU note. It's backed by nothing. They took all the gold off the streets in 1933. But his children, the Synagogue of Satan children, they caused the problem. Got you spending fake money, which every time you spend a dollar, the deficit go up because it's fake. I can go further, but that's far enough for that. But they caused the problem. They caused the problem, and then they solve it. The solution for this country is they finna collapse it. And Yah's gonna let them collapse it because of what they did to his children, what they're doing to his children. Oh, he gonna pay the mothers too. But he finna deal with this Babylonian whore, according to Revelation 17 and 18. They got the whole world drunk on the wine of her fornication. She's pushing this. She's pushing it hard, and she's finna pay for it. But this is the condemnation because the solution is here. See, folks is partying on the Titanic. Titanic already hit the iceberg. But people is partying like it's 1999 with them butt-out pants. You got the pants on, but your butt cheeks is out like Prince. Butt cheeks is out. Party like it 1999. And that's the problem because the solution been here. And parents, we need to take responsibility for our children and our family because the solution been here. And then when you start finding out that what you've been calling the solution might be a part of the pollution, it's talking about your church. If it's Catholicized, if it's full of paganism, if it's celebrating all this paganistic, satanic positions, if it's not preaching the truth, don't even know the deity of Yah, biggest commandment in the book, he's one. They don't know that. But if they trying to live it, then when the truth come, they'll switch. But when you're fake, and because of religious pressure and people quick to say that the table of Yah is contemptible, according to Malachi, he had a problem with the priests because they said that the table of Yah is contemptible, changeable, alterable. It don't matter long as you got Jesus' state of mind, right? No, it's time to come out the paganism. It's time for the scales to fall off your eyes to stop being tricked into worshiping Satan. Now, if you live in the life, Yah is dealing with you. But when you really belong to him, as truth come, you change. You make the necessary adjustment. Notice the word necessary. You make the necessary alterations. I didn't know that. Then you change. Because to him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. When you didn't know, you just praising Yah. But when you start knowing, who want to take responsibility for truth? As truth come, are you going to change? I've been going here since I was two. But what about the big Christmas tree on the altar? They don't know yet. You mean the pastor got his head in the hole somewhere? He don't know? Is he getting ready for Easter? He still don't know that's Semiramis. They don't know that still? What they doing? Either peer pressure or I don't want to call nobody no names. But what, they ain't learning nothing? Is anyone going to stand up for Yah? Is anyone going to tear down their altars? and say, enough. Enough of this. Because this is the condemnation. You know what the problem is? I got to get out of here because this is sermonette, y'all. You know what the problem is? The condemnation is that the truth is here. That's the problem. The truth is here. Be different when you ain't got access to the truth. But the problem is the light is coming to the world. The truth is here. And men love darkness rather than light. Why? Because their deeds are evil. They're part of a church organization. They're getting paid. And they respect that more than they do Yah. In closing, Paul had to tear away from his religious organization in order to serve truth. Haven't you read that before? What makes you think you ain't got to do the same? He literally had to tear away from his religious organization in order to serve the word. And folks are so indoctrinated, so lazy, so willing to go against the grain. So it's so important to them to get along with the with this church community that they're not willing to do that. And you got some folks that don't want to come to them because their deeds is evil. That's how they make love. That's how they make their money. That's how they function daily, doing evil. So they don't want to hear all this, but this is the condemnation. Look at this, plain and simple. You want to know what the condemnation is? Because people rather continue to do what they're doing. And the real truth interrupts all that. It's like going bowling. And the word is the bowling ball. Knock down your whole little situation. But you'll be able to rise up to walk in the newness of life. For Yah so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Y'all be Baruch. Let's pray. Spirit of the Most High, we love you. Thank you for this opportunity to come before you, humbles. We know how. Praying that your word went forth with clarity, falling down the souls of your children, speaking of everlasting life. Parts that they didn't understand, give them a spirit of study. And we be careful to continue to follow you and to match the name of Yahushua HaMashiach. That's when we pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah, and all, amen. Bless you, Neil. Bless you, Beverly. Hey, if the word bless y'all, push the share button. You might lose some Facebook friends, but push the share button. If you're a supporter of this ministry, which is a cool thing, we like to help people too, to be honest. And you want to sow into the ministry, all you got to do is go to PayPal, put in DerrickMann5857 at yahoo.com. That's DerrickMann5857 at yahoo.com. Or you can go to the Cash App, 510-938-0144. And if you want to hang out and get in the word, talk about what I just talked, all you got to do is dial 302-202-1102, extension 815648. Again, 302-202-1102, extension 815648. Y'all be Baruch and Baruch Shalom. I'm done.